My name is Jean-Charles Villard, better known by my friends like Charlie. My father's French, my mother's Chilean, and I was born in Australia. And we constantly have been traveling to wine countries to see wine productions, and my father was one of the pioneers in these countries in producing good quality white wines, and then he was one of the first ones to plant Pinot Noir in this valley. When we arrived to this valley in Casablanca, there was only 80 hectares of vineyards planted. Today there's almost 6,000, 5,000 or something. I don't know the figures quite well, but we are one of the pioneers. We arrived to Chile in 1989, my father. And in that stage, there were some good reds, but there were no good whites in this country. My father discovered this valley and he said, well, I'm gonna be one of the first to make good whites. And as he did. Then I came along and I was in this valley. There were good whites, good Pinots were starting to pop up, and there wasn't any good reds. And I totally believe that making premium red wines in this valley was possible, but almost very interesting, because you're gonna have high natural acidities that gives you freshness in the wine, and it gives us a lot of life. It will age much better. The plants give less grapes naturally per plant, so we got a higher concentration in each bunch of grapes. And also it's in bush wine, so there's no rows, no wires, and we're trying to do something different, something unique, and also on a very steep hill and with very poor soils, so the plant gets quite stressed and it just represents from where it is and what the plant can give us. You can see this year we had very low production on the vineyards, but it's not a problem for us because that's what we're looking for, and that was the reason we planted like that. Now we're going to start processing the Syrah. We're just merging the grapes into the belt. We do a little selection on the belt, and then it goes to this destemmer. And then from the destemmer it falls into a bin. And from the bin we're going to go into some barrels. Looks good. Still have to clean a bit more the grapes, but it's degraining quite well. We're not pressing much the grains, so looks good. I'm putting in the indication of what side of the hill it is, the grapes, and what clone it is. This is Syrah 174, and it's the lower part of the hill. That's why I put bajo, because bajo means below. Because you have different kind of clones, so you want to know during the fermentation or once the wine is done, the difference between one clone and the other, and what, how to treat that wine, how to make it. It's got different characteristics than the others. This is a much more fruitier Syrah. The other one we're gonna do after the 525, it's much more bodier, more Australian, you know, bigger, with much more spicy. This is more fruitier, so this, I use different woods for this wine. And the other one I'm going to use a higher toast to give it some more body, etc. Every year I've got my mates, my friends, that come along. And what do I offer them? Nothing in exchange, it's just joyness, happiness, good food, good drinking, and to have a great moment and to make them live the experience of making wine and make them understand the joy of wine, and also so they get better culture in wine, because every time you do something in wine, you're going to learn more and to understand it better. I'm totally against those wines that are made in industrial ways, and also with not so much contact with the winemaker, because some winemakers can push themselves far from the wines and got other things to do. But I've chosen myself to be in this part of the way of winemaking, because it's the way I want to live. It's like people that want to go surfing for the rest of their life. If I want to be a winemaker, I don't want to be behind a desk. I want to be making the wine. That's why we're here turning the barrels constantly and making the wine, understanding, tasting the wine every day. That's the idea. It's a lot of passion, something that I love doing, of course, and we're trying to do something different. And that's why also we're doing a red wine from Casablanca, premium red wine, and it's all gentle and it's done with a lot of heart, and you'll always transmit that into the wine. Apart from taking longer, it takes much more work, but we try to get the most possible what the grape is giving us. So we try to perceive that. Obviously the wood gives another power to the wine, but as is it fermented before with the wood, it will keep all the varieties, the characters of the fruit, and that's why we try to do the less intervention as possible as other style of winemaking, and just to make it more unique from where it comes, from the soil, to represent that climate and that soil. I was always going to be, you know, the son of Thierry Villard, and that's why I said to myself, if I want to be part of this and get my name renowned, I have to make my own wine, and I did it and made the most expensive wine that we have now in the market. It's something so incredible that it can be so tasty, so full, and can so impressive that not one wine can be exactly the same as the other. It can come from the same vineyard. Year after year, it's going to represent something different. How the climate it was, how we did the vinification, and so pleasant to drink. And of course, it's got this alcohol that also gives us some joyness in a well matter, in good proportions, that it's something marvelous to experience, to do on top of that, and people just enjoy it so much and come to you and say, oh, what a great wine. It's very good. You can see it's got more tannins, more structure. Some very good tannins that after a year in barrel, it will just come nice and round. Very good potential, very happy. The people that consume this are people that have heard about it, have been recommended about it, and people that love drinking good wines. That's the kind of people, and that understand about good wines. This is not a wine that's gonna be overpowered from the wood. It's going to be elegant wine with a nice acidity, with longness. I do not like those fat wines, overpowered, full of wood. It's not my style. I try to make elegant wines that always you have a glass and invite you another glass. I want to do something nice, something elegant, something long, not fat. ¶¶